This video is brought to you by catbeast.com. Design your own custom snapbacks and hats.
Yo, what up, what up? It's the kid, CJ City. You already know what it is, CJ City TV. So briefly, I want to give you guys a slight comparison between the DMP Jordan 14s and the 2018 Last Shots. These sneakers will release tomorrow. I had these sneakers pretty early, but I've been sick and I wasn't able to do this review. But I did want to try to pump this out before the sneaker release so you guys can get a little comparison. Salute to my man Brian from Sneakerfiles. He did a video like this, but he compared the 2011 Last Shots. And I feel like the DMPs were way better. But this time, we got a little story switch, man. You know, the plot thickens. With the 2018, I feel like they really stepped their game up with these 2018s. The quality on here is crazy. And I'm going to cut away and I'm going to show you guys that comparison right now. So I hope you guys enjoy. All right, so let's just take a look at these two sneakers right here on the right side. We're going to have the DMP and then over there on the left, you are going to have your 2018 Last Shot. I feel like this is a different story here. That's why I want to do this, man. Before, you know, if you watch my man Brian's video from Sneakerfiles, you will notice that the DMP 14, I feel like, trumped that 2011 Last Shot. The quality on this was way better. The craftsmanship was way better. You know, just the little accents and the hits that they did on this sneaker were just way better than that 2011 version. But now that we have a 2018 Last Shot compared to the DMPs, I feel like it's a different story. So before, you guys could take a look at this. You know, this was the best leather that I had seen on a Jordan 14. Okay, guys, the leather right here is like A1. It's insane. I didn't think they could get any better than this. But now we have the 2018 Last Shot joints right here. Hopefully you guys could see, man, this not only is like really soft, it's really tumbled as well, guys. Take a look at the hits on there. It's just way more tumbled than this one. This, you guys can see like the tumble leather in there. And then, like, let's go ahead and take a look at this. It's just really smooth, you know. It's really soft, I will give them that, but you can't see as much tumbled leather on there. Same thing on the back here. If you guys take a look at the back, you know, it's really soft, but you don't really see like that tumbled hit like you will see on these 2018 joints right here. If you guys take a look at the back there, you will see it's just super tumble. So I feel like they one-upped the DMPs, man. I didn't think that was possible, but let's just go ahead and take a look at the flip side here. Same thing, man. You got the tumble leather, and then when you feel it, it's just extremely soft, man. It is really buttery. Let's just go ahead and take a look at the flip side on this DMP right here. Nice and soft, I will give them that, but you cannot see the tumble leather as much as you can on the Last Shot 14. So, you know, I can't believe it, but they found a way to make better leather than the DMP Jordan 14s. I feel like this was going to be kind of like your shattered backboards. This was going to be the standard. Everybody was going to do a compare and contrast to this leather because it was the best. But hey, man, I feel like this is taking the cake as far as Jordan 14s go. This is the best leather I've seen on a Jordan 14. It's way better than that 2011 crap. So you guys will be excited when you see that. Let's just take a quick look at some differences, man. You can see on this emblem right here, in true Ferrari fashion, it is like a Ferrari emblem. You have your pendant on the inside, and then you have like a layer of plastic covering that. When you take a look at the DMPs right here, you guys can see that it's not like a layer and then a plastic bubble that covers it. It's just a gold plate on here. So that is some differences there. As far as like the toe cap, this is all leather, and then the tongue, that's going to be all leather as well. When you guys take a look at this, you will see that you're gonna have your suede, and this is really buttery suede right here, guys. And then on the tongue, you have your suede there. So I feel like that's just preference. Do you guys like the leather, or do you guys prefer the suede? Me personally, I prefer the leather. See this leather on the toe cap and the tongue? I feel like that's just going to look fresher longer. You know, this suede is eventually going to wear out. It's going to run its course and it's going to look old. So But if you guys are fans of suede, this is really good suede. I like that suede. Let's just go ahead and take a look at the back here. Basically, everything is the same. We have our tire treading there, and then we have our 23 and then our Jumpman, but we have our 98 and then we have our Jumpman there. I like the 98 better. I don't know, man. I just like the little accents better. Speaking of accents, I do like the gold tips on the DMPs. And then when you take a look at your last shots, we are going to have our silver tips right there. But I just really wanted to do this video just to compare the leathers, guys, the quality, the craftsmanship. I feel like this was the best Jordan 14 that I have seen. And now the last shot Jordan 14s that are releasing tomorrow is the best quality on the Jordan 14, man. So yeah, drop those comments down below. Let us know if you guys are planning to cop this. If you guys have, you know, the DMPs, take a look at the quality when you guys get them in hand, man, and compare them, because like I said before, this was the best quality on a Jordan 14, and now the last shots are taking the cake. Basically, we have the same thing going on the bottom. We just have our fender in gold, and then we have our fender in red there. You know, no quality change there, but yeah, this was way better than that 2011 crap that they gave us. This is some really high quality, man. Leather, suede, everything is good money. So yeah, definitely worth the money. So there you have it, man. That's the comparison between the DMP Jordan 14s and the 2018 last shots. Drop those comments down below. Let me know what you guys are feeling as far as quality wise. As far as like colorway, man, I know this sneaker is nostalgic. Everybody loves the last shot. But like I said, before all of that, I felt like this was the best Jordan 14 that I have ever seen. This was crazy. And then, of course, the quality on here is the best, man. So drop those comments. Let me know which one you guys prefer. And yeah, that's basically going to wrap things up. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel. Hit that bell. Turn on those notifications so you guys can get an email alert every single time I upload brand new sneaker content. Until next time, I'm signing out. It's the Kid CJ City. I appreciate all the love. Peace.